Thanks. The new Queen City Tower going up quickly. Tonight we're getting a tour of Cincinnati's tallest building. It's already redefining the city's skyline. But what about other construction projects? News 5's Michelle Hopkins is live with our number 5 story.
Yeah, Jack, 1 million square feet of office and retail space. That's part of what Queen City Tower here represents. And believe it or not, most of the space here already spoken for. Tonight we're going inside one of the hottest properties in town. From the first floor, you can really see the lobby taking shape. A glass rotunda, space for a fountain, and retail. The folks at Eagle Realty very hush-hush about who's in.
Our goal would really be to be pretty much totally leased up by the time we open the building next year.
This space with a great view of Great American Ballpark still available. 80% of Queen City Tower already occupied. So what about the Banks project? Is their office tower still a go, even with a significant interest in Queen City? Well, the Banks people say yes. The plan is for a tower, 10 stories high, but this project is heavily dependent on pre-leasing and a lot of it. The first tenants are set to move into the Queen City Tower next January.
So we've had an opportunity to really upgrade the building to take advantage of new technologies and new improvements.
The crowning jewel of the tower, the tiara, should arrive in mid-April. A topping won't happen until mid-summer. Those backing the Queen City Tower say they want the project to be about the Queen City.
So we like people to, when they're out in different parts of the country, say, hey, we've got this great, new space going up downtown, and we're going to have a new skyline.
And workers lost about a week because of the winter weather. But even with that, the project, they say, is just about right on schedule. And look for the tower crane you see there to go up another 100 feet. That should happen right around April 1st. And again, getting ready for the tiara, which should arrive in mid-April. Kind of exciting. Reporting live, Michelle Hopkins, News 5.